सर थोड़ा आप सामने आ जाइए सर प्लीज
of the building, architectural beauty you have seen. What else do you need for a court complex like this? I was told that this building was completed about 4 years back, and it was here for reasons which we did not go into. It was not being put to use, and it was in October 2018, when the present Chief Justice, Justice Gogoi, took over, and when he initiated a process to ensure that all judicial posts in the subordinate judiciaries are filled up, that the urgent need for having additional court complexes in Delhi was felt. Why? Because the Honorable Chief Justice of India took up the matter on the judicial side, and notices were issued to each high court and the state government. And as it had been on the first day in October itself, Delhi's chance came up, and we had to tell the high court that we have about 282 vacancies. We were asked, why are we not filling it up? We said, we are short of more than 160 court rooms. The Chief Justice said, I don't know, you have to fill up on the post, make arrangements. And therefore, the High Court started the search for additional accommodation for accommodating more than 187 court rooms. And in that process, when I sat with Justice Ravindra Bhatt, Justice Sistani, and other officials of the registry, we found that the Rouse Avenue court complex is already ready. It can be made operational with certain finishing touches to be given, furnishing, computerization, electrification, etc. And more than 42 courts can be accommodated in this complex. And at that point of time, a batch of the 2016-17 judicial officers were undergoing training, and we were informed that before 31st of March we would have about 48 judicial officers ready to join duties. And that is when we thought that we have no other option but to make this court complex operational. Then the question arose as to which court should be shifted to this complex. I was told that there was already a full court decision for shifting the CBI courts and the Motor Accident Claims Tribunal courts. We interacted with the members of the bar, and I have to say from the bottom of my heart that the members of the bar cooperated. The members of the coordination committee made a request that we may reconsider the question of shifting the motor accident claims tribunals. Instead, we may consider for shifting some other courts. And therefore, after deliberation, initially we thought of shifting the courts dealing with financial institute cases, that is under Section 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act. The bar had certain reservations. And then the idea came that we can shift the labor courts, which are housed in the Dwarka court complex. The Labour Bar Association made a request that the Dwarka court complex is not convenient for them. Even the litigants who have to come from various factories where they are working, and if their courts are shifted to the Rouse Avenue, it would be convenient for them. And that is how the final decision was taken after approval of the full court for shifting the CBI special courts and the labour courts that are housed in Dwarka. In the meanwhile, the judicial officer had completed their training. On 26th of March, we had their valedictory function, and when their appointment orders were issued, we told them that you have to join on 9th of April, that is tomorrow. Otherwise, the High Court would have more than 50 officers without any courtroom to sit and without any place to work. Anticipating all these things, the Chief Secretary, the Chief Engineers of the PWD, Mr. Chauhan, all were called, and I can tell you that within 3 months they did what you are seeing today. Still, there are certain things to be completed, but our endeavor in commencing the course from tomorrow is completed. Initially, we had thought of having a grand function and having an inauguration of a court of this magnitude and complex in a grand way, but time constraint and the requirement of having this court functional tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. made us to think that let us have a function and make it operational from tomorrow. And then in initiating this process, and the officers of the subordinate district courts, particularly the team Mr. Talwant Singh and his team from the central district, because it is the central district which is the parent district court, which is administratively and judicially under the statute which would under whom this court would be functioning. Everybody stood, worked shoulder to shoulder, and I am happy to say that from tomorrow onwards this court would become functional. Yes, it's a new complex. We will have a lot of teething problem, but I can assure each one of you that we'll resolve all with the cooperation of each one concerned. I would be failing in my duty if I don't mention something about the apprehensions of certain section of the members of the bar. Initially, when this court complex was conceived and we had decided to shift it, we had an issue as to how we will manage the day-to-day administrative function of this building. Even though Mr. Talwant Singh was in charge, district judge, but for administering the building from Tees Hazari would have been difficult. And therefore, we thought of getting an additional post of district and session judge sanctioned and posting him here to be the administrative head for dealing with the day-to-day administrative problems. And when this notification was issued by the government appointing him as the additional district and session judge, the members of the bar apprehended that a 12th district had been created in Delhi without taking us into confidence, without telling us. We held a meeting with them. The members of the coordination committee came to us. We explained to them that no, there are only 11 districts. This court complex is part of the central district and it will function under the aegis of the central district only. And what has been done by appointing a district and session judge is only to take care of the day-to-day administrative work and certain small statutory requirements which are to be fulfilled in the day-to-day conduct of trial, particularly with cases under the Prevention of Corruption Act. The bar was convinced and we went ahead with the inaugural function. When all of a sudden, when my registry published this invitation card, they said, Rouse Avenue District Court Complex, a new controversy started. They said, no, the Chief Justice and the judges told us that it's a part of the central district, but it speaks about a district court complex and therefore it's a separate district. I have to tell the members of the bar that please don't go by the nomenclature of a building. You have such a beautiful building, I cannot call it a sub-court building or a sub-district court building. The naming, the nomenclature of the building has to be in conformity and looking to the nature of the building. And merely because we call it a district court complex, it does not mean that it's a separate building.